गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मराठा विद्या प्रसार समाज के आर टी आर्ट्स बी एच कॉमर्स एंड एम साइंस अलाइज के डी एच एम कॉलेज नासिक डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स क्लास टी वाई बी कॉम. द पेपर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग एंड एप्लीकेशन पेपर 2013 पैटर्न. सब्जेक्ट कोड ऑफ आवर पेपर इज 305L एंड द टॉपिक टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन टू syllabus. I'll introduce myself first. I'm Mr. Satish Kedarav Dharra. The very first lesson that we are going to study is computer networks. In computer networks, we are going to study introduction to computer network, topologies and types of networks. So student, let me know you that what is computer network. In simple terms, a computer network is a collection of computers connected together with an intention to share resources. Such formation of computers where they are connected using some transmission media and some software, a combination of hardware and software, it makes a network. So we are going to study in detail what is computer network, what are its components, what are its types, and many more things regarding computer network. And the second term that we are going to study is topology. Topology means the arrangement of computers in the network. It has came from the Greek word topos. Topos means the art of arranging the things. So how the computers in the network, they are arranged? What are the different ways in which the computers can be arranged in the network? So basically there are two types of topologies: physical topology and logical topology. So we are going to discuss the details of this topology in our next sessions to come over. Then the next topic that we are going to learn in this first lesson, computer networks, is about the types of networks. So what are the different types of networks? You might have heard earlier that LAN, MAN, WAN. Then there are different types of configurations of networks, such as client server networks, then peer-to-peer networks, and so many. So we are going to discuss all these things in details in our forthcoming sessions, but for the time being, just remember that you are going to study computer network and its allied topics such as topologies, types of networks, and many more things to come. Then second is the communication types. There are basically two types of communications: serial and parallel communication. As you all know that you must be watching the serials on Netflix, you are watching serials on television. Serial means something that comes one after another. So the sequential input or output, we'll call it as serial. And parallel means once at a time. So how the communication is going to take place, whether it is going to take serial or parallel, what are the benefits, pros and cons of serial, what are the pros and cons of parallel, that we are going to study in this topic, communication types, serial and parallel. Then the next topic that we are going to study is modes of communication. So basically there are three types of modes of communication: simplex, half duplex, full duplex. So the communication right we are having is the type of simplex. That is, I'm able to communicate with you, but you are not able to communicate with me. So this one-way communication, totally one-way communication, is called as simplex communication. And the best example is broadcasting. So you're watching televisions, you're watching mostly it is about television nowadays, because many of the Netflix and they are coming with some interactive media. So that is not going to be the example of simplex. The simple example is the television, where the things are broadcasted, one-way communication takes place, you are not able to communicate with each other. So that is the simplex communication. Radio communication is also a type of simplex type of communication, where you don't have the option to communicate vice versa. Only one-way communication is possible. So that is simplex communication. Then the next comes is the half duplex communication. Half duplex means one at a time. That kind of communication is called as half duplex communication. Full duplex communication means where both the parties, they are able to communicate with each other. That communication is called as full duplex communications. Then we are going to discuss about the servers, server-based LANs, peer-to-peer LANs, and then comparison of the both. As I discussed earlier, that these two, server-based and peer-to-peer, are the configurations of networks. So normally the networks are configured either as server-based, that is client-server, or peer-to-peer means where all are equal, and in server there is one computer which serves the need of all and the others are requesting for services from the main computer called as server. So what is it? How, what are the terminologies associated in server-based LANs and peer-to-peer LANs? Then we are going to study the comparison of both of these. The next is that since we are into networks, we have understood that what are the different types of networks, how they communicate with each other, what are their modes of communication, how they are configured. For all above, one important thing is required, that is the protocols and standards. So in any community, wherever you want to have a society where there should be a good environment, in that case they have to follow certain protocols and standards. So protocols means rules, and standards means some assumptions which everyone has to follow. So those assumptions, they become rules and we call them as standards, and these standards and protocols is the next topic that we are going to study. For example, here in standards means what? If I'm going to speak in some other languages, since we are in Maharashtra, in Nashik, so the language of communication normally we are accustomed to is Marathi, English and Hindi. But all of a sudden, if I start speaking Spanish or French, there won't be a meaningful communication between you and me. So the established standard for communication between you and me is the language. So normally, either I'm going to speak with you in Marathi or Hindi or English. So that is standard. So if the standards are taken into consideration, then the things becomes uniform, and thus the communication becomes more faster and without any hitch and glitch. So this was all about our first chapter, computer networks, where we are going to study the computer networks, topologies, types of networks. And in the second part, we are going to study communication types, basically two types, serial and parallel. Then the next is modes of communication. These modes of communications are simplex, half duplex, full duplex and server based. LANs are there, peer-to-peer LANs are there. So comparison between server-based LANs and peer-to-peer LANs we are going to study here. Then the next is protocols and standards. So for all above to happen, they need to follow some standards and protocols. So the study of those standards and protocols is going to be the last topic that we are going to study. The second lesson that we are going to study is network models. As you all know, models means a standard structure out of which we understand in simplest form. Those models, they are called as models. Those structures, they are called as models. So to design these networks, we need to have some network models. Into this network models, there are some layers. So in this model, one important thing is that there are reference layers discussed here in this lesson. These reference layers, they are going to have design issues, they are going to have protocol hierarchy, that in what way they are going to interact with each other. So that is their protocol hierarchy, design issues here. The word issues have different meaning. Issues means to give, issues means to have a baby born, and many more things. But here issues means the topic that are related with the design of the layer. So that is design issues. So make very clear in your mind, here issues means the topics that are related with the design of the layer that you are going to study. The next topic is protocol hierarchy. Protocols, as I discussed earlier, protocol means rules and hierarchy means the what we may say is that there are levels of interaction, that is called as protocol hierarchy. So a simple example, if I'm going to give, of hierarchy is like in a school system or in a college system, a student is at the center, followed by the teacher, followed by the principal, followed by the management, followed by the government. So there is an hierarchy, or hierarchy, you may spell it any way. So there is some level. So this levels of protocols that we are going to study, and that topic is protocol hierarchy. Then the next we are going to study is the ISO OSI reference model. As discussed earlier, this the design issues of the layers, they are basically for this ISO OSI reference model. ISO is International Standard Organization, whereas OSI is Open System Interconnect. This organization has come up with a reference model for communication between different computers on networks. So this OSI has given some reference models as discussed earlier. Model means a standard structure that is designed to understand the things in miniature. So the things are created in miniature, and then as you go to your architect for building a house, he gives you a prototype or a model, and then from that model you understand that how could be your building. In the same way, this ISO OSI reference model has given a structure of protocols, how they should be, how the layers are going to behave with each other, what is going to be their design issues at each layer, how the protocol hierarchy is going to be there. All these things are discussed in detail in this ISO OSI reference model. Basically, we are going to study two reference models. The first one is the standard OSI reference model, and the second one is the TCP/IP reference model. And then we are going to study the design issues of these models at each layer. So it is nothing but the function of each layer. Then we are going to study the terminologies associated with these reference models: SAP, connection oriented services, connection less services, peer entities. What are all these terms we are going to study in this next topic about terminologies. Then, as I discussed earlier, that there are two models that we are going to study. The first one is the ISO OSI reference model, and the second one is the TCP/IP model. What are these two models? The comparison of these two models is going to be the next topic of our discussion. At the end, we are going to discuss about the addressing types. Basically, there are two types of addressing: physical addressing and logical addressing, along with port addresses. Whereas the IP addressing is classful addressing and classless addressing. So we are going to discuss what is meant by classful addressing, what is meant by classless addressing in detail in our forthcoming sessions of our lesson Network Models for the subject Computer Networks Paper 2. The third lesson that we are going to study is transmission media. As we had discussed earlier, that when we are going to connect two computers together, we need some mean or a medium to communicate with this, to make communication possible between these two computers, and that is made possible by transmission media. So basically, there are two types of transmission media: guided transmission media and unguided transmission media. Guided media is also called as wired media, and unguided is called as wireless transmission media. So why it is called as guided media, why it is called as unguided media, why it is called as wired and wireless, so all those concepts we are going to discuss in detail in our forthcoming sessions of transmission media. Basically, the transmission media of the type guided or wired or directed, another word for guided media or wired media is the directed media. So the directed media that we are going to study is first coaxial cable. In coaxial cable, we are going to study its physical structure, its standards, then the connectors associated with coaxial cable. Basically, BNC connector is required to connect this coaxial cable with each other to bring out communication. BNC stands for Binet Navy Connector. then what are the different applications of coaxial cables that we are going to study. You have seen this cable at your home. The cable television which you are having at your home, it comes with this coaxial media or this coaxial cable. So we are going to discuss all these things. Then the next type of cable that we are going to study in guided or wired media is the twisted pair cable. In twisted pair cable, we are going to study its physical structure. We are going to understand that what are the different types of twisted pair cables. Basically, there are two types of twisted pair cables, UTP cable and STP cable. UTP is unshielded twisted pair, whereas STP is shielded twisted pair. What are the connectors that are associated with this transmission media of the type twisted pairs and its applications is the topic of our discussion for the topic twisted pair in the lesson transmission media. Then the third important guided media that we are going to study is fiber optics cable. In our modern world, the backbone of internet has been developed using fiber optic cables. The fiber optic cable, what are its pros, what are its cons, what is its structure, physical structure, what are its propagation methods, that in what way it communicates, then what are the connectors that are going to be used. This fiber optic transmission media is going to be the next topic of our discussions in the lesson transmission media. We are also going to understand the different applications of this transmission media fiber optic cable of the type guided media. So dear students, in this media transmission, in this topic transmission media, we are going to discuss two types of transmission media, guided media and unguided transmission media. In guided or wired transmission media, we are going to study coaxial cable, twisted pair cable, fiber optic cable with reference to their physical structure, their standards, the connectors used with them and the application associated with this types of transmission media. And the last topic that we are going to study in this lesson transmission media is the unguided transmission media, which we called as wireless transmission media. This wireless transmission media comes with different types of unguided media comes with different types of transmission medias. They are depending upon their propagation methods, such as ground, sky, line of sight, wireless transmission media. The different types are radio waves and infrared. So the propagation methods define the type of transmission media. The propagation methods of the media, they may be from ground, may be from sky, may be from line of sight. So I want to discuss with you that what is this propagation media, what do you mean by the ground propagation methods, the sky propagation methods and the line of sight. So that is going to be our next topic that we are going to study here. The last lesson for the semester that we are going to study is wired LANs Ethernet. So this connection of computers together, it is called as Ethernet, and since we are going to connect it with wire, so the next topic that we are going to study is wired LANs Ethernet. In this we are going to study that what are the Ethernet standards. Basically IEEE standards are governing the communication between the computers or the Ethernet LANs. So what are the standard Ethernets, how they are going to behave at different layers. Basically they are going to behave or interact at the media access control sub layer of the digilink layer of, then the next is your physical layer. Then the next type of Ethernet is the fast Ethernet, which works at MAC sub layer and physical layer. Nowadays the popular is the gigabit Ethernet, which again all these Ethernet standards normally they apply at or they interact at MAC sub layer and physical layer. For this computers to be connected, we need a network interface card. So what are the different types of network interface cards? What are the different components of network interface cards? What are the functions of network interface cards? All these topics that are going to be the topics of our discussion in our forthcoming sessions of computer programming and application paper 2 for the class TYBCOM. So for the time being, we'll stop here. In our next session, we're going to begin with our first lesson. Till then, goodbye. Thank you. That's all for today. Jai Hind.